For International Star Wars Day, we're going to show you how we built the world's first real-life Kylo Ren proto-saber. Make sure you watch the whole video because we're going to do a massive Star Wars giveaway, including your very own lightsaber. Thanks to our sponsor, Honey. May the Force be with you. Kylo Ren has a badass lightsaber. Not only does it have a unique crossguard, but according to lore, Kylo constructed it with a cracked Kyber crystal, giving it a violent, unstable appearance and sound. I'll let you in on a little secret. We've actually been developing our own Kylo Ren lightsaber behind the scenes for well over the past year, and we even have a few ideas how to create the cracked crystal look as well. So why don't we catch you up on the progress so far? If you've been following our channel, you know that lightsabers are nothing new for us. In fact, our very first lightsaber build was already almost 3 years ago.
Look at that, that is red hot steel. That's, oh, it's getting, oh my God, it works. Guys, it actually works.
And thankfully, that first build was the only one that resulted in emergency services showing up. Since then, we've been through several iterations, and with each version, we've learned something new. Our first experiment used pure tungsten as a blade. Running over 10 kilowatts of electricity through it resulted in a hot yellow glow. But we discovered that tungsten flakes off material at this temperature, releases a lot of potentially poisonous gases, and gets floppy. Our second iteration featured a stainless steel ball screw threaded core covered in a ceramic insulator with nitinol wire wrapped around the grooves. This glowed a solid orange yellow, but the longer it was on, the weaker the steel core became, resulting in a floppy lightsaber, not unlike the Schwartz lightsaber rings from Spaceballs. Oh. And it was high voltage DC, which is rather dangerous. As you can see, we had some rather bright arc flashes when the whole blade shorted out. Which brings us to our third iteration, a titanium shell over a ceramically insulated tungsten core. By running about 20 kilowatts of electricity through it, the titanium glows yellow-white hot at around 1500 Celsius. But because tungsten has a much higher melting point than titanium, the blade remains rigid and solid. Since this discovery, we've refined both the manufacturing process and the size of both the titanium and tungsten for optimal performance. And we're quite happy with how robust the new blades are compared to our first attempts. If you want an in-depth look at our entire development process, make sure you check those videos out. Once we were happy with our finalized prototype, it was time to build a second lightsaber so we can live out every Star Wars fan's fantasy, a lightsaber duel. I mean, what's really the point otherwise? Make sure you check out that video as it was one of the most dangerous things we've ever done. On camera, anyway.
That's enough of a history lesson. It's time to build a lightsaber. I've actually been working on this for over a year now. Right after building the first titanium lightsaber, I started thinking, if I can get one blade red hot, why not three? All I would need to do is electrically connect the three blades in series in such a way that it fits inside of the hilt and can handle a couple thousand amps without melting. Pretty simple, right? With a series configuration, each blade will heat up the same amount because they all have the same current. I decided to go with metal 3D printing because, well, printing titanium is really cool, and it lets me create some interesting geometry that would be really difficult to machine. Okay, the design is done, now we just need to get it metal 3D printed. Luckily, James used to work with Mark Barfoot, who is the director of additive manufacturing at EWI. Mark and EWI were instrumental in making this possible. We just sent them the CAD model and he took care of the rest. Oddly enough, EWI didn't actually print any of the parts themselves because we couldn't get any machine time. Instead, they got EOS in Germany to print the copper parts, and they got Renishaw to print the titanium parts. Renishaw actually has a Kitchener office, meaning that we got to go see the parts being printed firsthand.
Alright, we're at Renishaw, and I'm super excited because the parts are coming out of the machine today.
There it is.
It's looking good.
So basically we worked through the glove box to get all of the powder out of the machine. I'm gonna put stuff on, you guys can look through the window. I'm gonna just vacuum the bolts, pull it out, and then you guys can come back in when I get on the bench and
great.
Do some shots of the hearts.
When you're working with metal powders, things can be quite explosive or dangerous, so because of that, we have to be outside of the room right now while he's just finishing up processing parts. It's pretty porous right now.
Yeah, it's like a casting finish.
Yeah, I'm hoping that we can keep that finish.
So, yeah.
This looks really nice, though. Cool. I'm excited to try to put it together.
I'm
really hoping my tolerances fit well. Okay, so this slots onto this, and then this piece screws onto both of them and holds it all together. So the interesting thing is, this is the kind of thing you can do with 3D printing that's more difficult with machining, is that both this piece and this piece are threaded separately, and then this threads on over top.
Alright, so as you know, Kylo Ren's lightsaber is a little bit different than every other lightsaber we've seen in Star Wars. In addition to having the crossguard, it also uses a cracked Kyber crystal, which gives the blade a very unstable, crackling effect. Well, I've got two commonly available chemicals here, cupric chloride and strontium chloride. These are used in fireworks. Cupric chloride glows a nice green, and strontium a red. It's used in road flares as well. And to demonstrate, I've got some on the table right here. All right, let's try the cupric chloride first. Woo! Nice blue-green, look at that. Cool. And then we have the strontium, which burns, woo! Nice and red. So what we've done is we've taken these basic chemicals, which are actually salts technically, and we've mixed them with a binder. So I don't know if you can see that, but we have the cupric chloride over here, and we have the strontium chloride over here. So hypothetically, we're gonna get red flame here, green flame there, which means we'll be able to have a colored lightsaber. Ready? Don't breathe this. Will it ignite? That is the question. Or will it just suffocate us with poisonous fumes? Oh, it's on fire, but not in color. Oh, that's disappointing. So to answer the question, no, we cannot color the lightsaber blade, unless we make one out of plasma. We do all of our shopping online these days, which is why it's important to find the best deals. But why is it so hard to find coupon codes that actually work? Well, with Honey, it doesn't have to be. Honey is a free online shopping tool that'll find the best promo codes and automatically apply them to your cart to save you money. It works at tons of sites like Amazon, eBay, Newegg, Best Buy, Walmart, and more. And when you check out, this little box drops down and all you have to do is click apply coupons. It'll scan available codes across the internet and you can watch as the prices drop. Since we love Star Wars and it's May the 4th, we wanted to give something back to our audience. So let's go shopping at Zabby, a site where we buy a lot of our props for our projects. I've always wanted a Darth Vader helmet. Boba Fett t-shirt? Why not? How about an official Medal of Yavin? Finally, Mace Windu's lightsaber. Let's see how much we saved. 20 pounds. Not bad. I love saving money. But as a special treat for our viewers, I've negotiated an even bigger coupon you can use at Zabby. Install Honey today to automatically apply this coupon on your next order. Plus, if you install Honey and sign up using the link below, you'll be entered to win these Star Wars items in a giveaway. I know. You were hoping we were going to give away one of our real-life proto-sabers. But I spoke to our lawyers, and unless we want to get sued to oblivion, we simply can't give away something so dangerous. Besides, the Mace Windu lightsaber has full sound effects, you can hit your friends without cutting their heads off, and it's an officially licensed Star Wars product. Honey supports over 30,000 stores online and has saved its 17 million members over $2 billion so far. By not having Honey, you could literally be passing up free money. It's free to use and installs in just two clicks. Get Honey for free at joinhoney.com/hacksmith. That's joinhoney.com/hacksmith. Thanks Honey for sponsoring today's video.
All right, I got all the 3D printed parts and they look amazing. The next step is to remove all the support material, this stuff here, and that might be difficult because it's also titanium. So cutting off titanium is difficult. So we'll see how that goes. Okay, that was difficult to say the least. Turns out titanium is very hard, very difficult to work with in general, so I managed to get it out. I went through several grinding discs, end mills, all sorts of drill bits. It just destroys everything, but I got it. The next step is to, I still need to machine the surface off,
drill them out and then tap these holes and then machine some of the inner components. Let's get started. Well, that doesn't seem to be working.
Alrighty.
Oh. I've probably destroyed that bit, and I've taken pretty well nothing off. Okay, I swapped it out for a bigger tool. Hopefully this will work. Seems to be working so far. I'm making these Teflon brackets in order to hold the copper emitters. These electrically insulate from the rest of the system while holding it firm, which is what I need. Firm. Okay, so the next step is to tap this hole right here, and this is going to be very difficult because, again, titanium. It's just very hard. Last time I did this was aluminum, and it was still very hard. I've gone ahead and made a custom tool, just a big bar. Give me lots of levers. Let's see how this goes. Easy so far, but I'm only just getting started. And I have a lot of leverage. All right then. My next step is to tap this hole, and I'm worried about that because the last time I tapped something on it, that was this one right here, I broke the tap. This is a much finer tap, so I'm concerned it's not going to go well, but let's give it a go. So it actually worked. I think I ruined my tap, but it did work. I'm just gonna give these copper parts a quick shine with the wire brush. I'm making some battery bus bars so I can connect the 8 Genzace Tattoo batteries in parallel. That is awesome. Just need to wire it up, and then we can turn it on. I got some stainless steel sheathing, which I'm gonna use to protect the wires. Last time I used fiberglass, but I thought this would look nicer. All right, this is the final step. Just need to plug in these wires, which lead to the battery terminals, and then we'll be ready to test. It's all done. All I need to do is plug it in. I'm going to use the same battery pack as the last lightsaber for our lightsaber duel. You should check out that video. Just need to plug it in. Of course, the circuit diagram is the same as the last one. I'm using the same contactor. If you missed that, you can check it out on maker.io. Okay. Super excited to turn this on for the first time. I started this project way before the quarantine, but since then I've been working on weekends. So all alone here, might as well try it out. Here we go. Heating up. Oh yeah. Look at that. Yeah, that's pretty hot. All right, I'm happy with that. You happy with that? Ta 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 ta. Epic beauty shots. I'll leave a note for James so he can find this on Monday. I think he'll like it.
Ian said he left a surprise for me here. Did he finish the Kylo Ren lightsaber? Don't burn your hand off. Who do I look like, Anakin? Let's turn this thing on. All right, here, I should probably wear safety glasses, knowing Ian made this. And I should probably turn off the lights. Hey Jarvis, can you turn the lights off? Oh, that's got some weight to it. The three tungsten blades, it is pretty heavy. I'm kind of nervous to turn it on. See, it's just like starting to heat up there. And now the, oh. That is freaking cool. We got bright, glowing Kylo Ren proto saber. Man, I thought the heat off the old proto sabers was a lot, but like, whoo. This is highly dangerous. Let's go test her out. Hey, what are those? Who left these balloons here? Oh, oh, oh. That's freaking sweet. All right, this just might be my favorite lightsaber we've built yet. It is freaking awesome. The 3D printed titanium looks amazing. I think it's probably our most authentic Star Wars project we've done. Now, you guys are gonna wanna make sure you subscribe to our channel because we're not done with lightsabers yet. First of all, we may or may not be collaborating with a certain famous YouTuber to let him try out this lightsaber. And second of all, we've already started designing a retractable plasma-based lightsaber, which will be the world's most realistic lightsaber. And we figured out how to make that one a different color. So make sure you're subscribed, hit that notification bell, and if you want to win that Star Wars giveaway, make sure you sign up for Honey using the link below.